many times am I going to tell you?
Papa?
How many times? Banging on pots and pans and garbage can covers wasn't enough noise for you. And driving us all crazy by playing on the washboard with Mother's thimble? That was not enough noise either.
But it doesn't have to be noise. There's music and drums, Papa. I know there is. I don't know how to tell you. Well, sometimes it can be real quiet music, too. Papa, did you know the drums were the first instrument man ever played? It's true. Did you know that?
I've been too easy with my baby son.
Papa, I'm 18 years old. Why do you treat me like a kid?
Why do you act like one? At your age, I was already working for 8 years. But I wanted you to be somebody.
But I think I can be somebody as a drummer.
Somebody fine. A priest, maybe.
But I want to be a drummer.
Why?
Papa, if I told you why, I'd be lying. I don't know why.
Now, listen to me, my son. In 1 month from now, you are graduating from high school. It is time that you understood that there are men walking the streets begging for work. And you? Where did you get this thing with drums? From the devil himself?
No, Papa.
Then get rid of them. Didn't you hear me?
I can't, Papa.
Didn't you hear me? How many times am I going to tell you? And tell you, and tell you, and tell you, and tell you, and tell you.
Why don't you kick me too, Pop? You might just as well.
Don't talk, Eugene. It's no use.
No, that's right. Because I'm going to get me another set of drums. I don't know how, but I will. And if you break those, I'm going to get me another set and another after that. Because you're right. I'm not a baby anymore. I'm getting a chance to play with a bunch of guys at Austin High. They formed a band, and they play jobs for money, Pop. That's what I'm going to do. Oh, can't you see, Pop? I gotta.
Fill him for Davy Tuff when he cuts out for New York. But the good Lord never closes one door without opening another.
Hi.
Oh, hi.
We met last week.
Yeah, I know.
Oh. Would you like some?
Oh, thanks.
What?
I was just trying to remember if I thank you for the gum.
You're funny.
I'm not.
Whom are you beating on those drums? Well, that's how you were playing just now. Like there was some kind of devil in those drums you just had to beat out of there.
There is. His name is Nobody. Mr. Nobody. And he wants me to be just like him, see?
Hey, I thought he liked that, huh? He sure tore things up, didn't he?
Yeah.
All right, you guys, come on. That's enough playing for ourselves. Let's rehearse for the job before my folks get home, huh? Come on, Gene.
Hi, new boy. Where have you been?
One, two.
Don't knock yourself out. We're having a weenie roast and swim party at my house next Saturday, and you're my date.
Let there be you, and let there be me. Let there be oysters under the sea. Let there be wind and occasional rain. Chili con carne and some sparkling champagne. Let there be birds to sing in the trees and someone to bless me whenever I sneeze. Let there be cuckoos, a lark and a dove, but first of all, please, let there be love. Let there be love. Let there be love.
What'll you have?
Oh. One of those? Hey, do you think drummers ever get to live like that?
Not by playing at marathons. Or that dime a dance palace you played last night.
You know, I'll bet everyone even has his own room up there. Do you?
Well, I'm an only child.
Oh, that's nice.
Is it? Well, I always thought having brothers and sisters was the nicest. Are they all like you? Shy and so quiet? Until you get behind those drums, then boom, look out, I'm coming at you, so hear me good. It's like drums must have been when they began back there in the jungle. Voodoo drums making black magic, getting everybody all shook up like.
You say those things to surprise yourself?
I'll shut up.
No, I like the way you talk. Hey, I bet you can write a book.
I'll bet I couldn't. Besides, I'd much rather write music.
Your father, doesn't he mind?
No. Does yours?
He wants me to be a priest.
You love him, don't you?
Like he was God. Hey, listen, what are you doing after graduation?
Oh, I know what I'd like to do. Go to New York and study at the Juilliard School of Music. And maybe one day, if God is good to me, I'd hear a symphony of mine played at Carnegie Hall. And I'd get married and have a house full of kids with...
Hey, drummer boy, come quick. I need your help. Come on, hurry.
Can I bite your lower lip?
I thought you needed help.
Oh, I do, baby, I do. That moon and that music. Don't you want it?
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
For me, Father, because something is wrong. I thought I had it made, but the rain drips and somebody walks a certain way. The rhythm beats everything else out of my head. I hear an Ave Maria and my mind takes off on a syncopated version of it. Father, I know I'm profaning something that's holy. I know. I just can't help it. I tried. I really have.
I know you have. And becoming a priest is a fulfillment, not a penance. If you feel certain that it wasn't meant to be and you wish to leave...
No, I can't. I promise them. I'll make it.
In 6 weeks, summer vacation will be here. You'll go home, get some rest and peace.
Tell him fat, huh? Hey, Ed, how come you guys are putting out in a speakeasy like this, huh?
Oh, we're lucky. Boy, the kind of places that let us play our music, you can count on your nose. So here we play it the way we like. Hey, Jane?
Huh?
Well, you know, we can sure use you around here. What do you say, huh?
What's to say? A guy's gonna be a priest. He can't... Yeah. Well, you know.
Sure, I know. What are you going to do all summer?
Oh, I don't know. My mother's... I don't know, Eddie.
Gee, well, look, maybe she wouldn't mind if you just played for the summer, huh? Maybe.
Has she... Maybe.
Yeah? Boy, that's it. You really put me on the sunny side. Hey, did you hear about Davy Tuff? He went to New York and made it with Paul Whiteman.
No kidding. Hey, what's she doing here?
Oh, it's, we've been dating kind of steady, you know. Yeah, I tell you, it's crazy. I just look at her and she knocks me apart. I'll tell you something even crazy. I'm gonna marry her. I have an S here, so don't say anything, all right?
Hi.
Oh, no.
All right. Hi, Ed.
Hello, Jane.
Hello.
Eddie told me you might be around today, and I just had to come and say hello and catch some of that scary drumming.
Scary?
It always scared me. Didn't you know that? Are my eyebrows off or something?
You've changed.
It's been a year. Almost.
No more gum?
Huh? I haven't changed that much. You remembered.
I tried not to.
Didn't you write to anybody?
Well, it was better that way. You look good, Eth.
I feel good.
It shows. Excuse me. Hey, Eddie, hey, what's that?
Oh, they're just testing. See, in case of a raid, the light blinks a warning from the front door. That is, unless you blow out the man's fuse box. If you remember how.
Not to call me that.
Okay, Padre. You know I love you, too. Come on, I'll even buy you a drink to prove it.
You know I don't drink. Even if I did, I wouldn't drink with a big noise.
Oh, keep tangling her for? You know she's only trying to get a rise out of you. Every time she comes in,
she's nothing but a big noise. Look, just because one of her boyfriends owns this joint, that doesn't mean I can't...
Oh, he not only owns the place, but he's liable to open up your head to see why you don't use your brains while you still got them.
It's Krupa.
Huh? Hello, Mama. Ted?
Eugene?
Mama, would you like to come in and sit down, huh? Come on in. What are you looking for, Mama?
I wanted to know where my son is working and with what kind of people. Thank God that soon you will be going back to the seminary.
Mama, I'm not going back. I can't.
Don't say that.
I've got to, Mama.
Don't say it.
Mama, I can never be a priest. I wish I could be, but I just don't have it in me. Mama, come on, don't look at me that way. I tried, Ma. I really tried for a whole year, but that life is just not for me.
And this life is for you? In dark cellars filled with smoke, shameless men and women drinking alcohol, breaking the law, while you entertain them. This is the life you have chosen? This filth?
Compliments of Miss Correggio, sir.
Take it away. Listen, Mama, if the whole world wants to drink and to go crazy, how is that my fault? All I want to do is make my kind of music, and I'm doing that. Mama, did you hear the waiter? Sir, he called me. Not, hey, kid, hey, squirt, but sir. That's what I am around here, Mama, and I like that. I have a job, money, friends. Mama, why are you crying? Being a musician doesn't have to be bad. Ma, where are you going? Are you at least going to listen to me play?
Here? Your father was right.
Mama! Mama, why don't you tell me what you used to say about Papa?
Don't you dare to mention his name in this place.
You said it didn't matter what a man did, but what he was. If I was meant to be a priest, Ma...
You are worse than they. Because your father taught you to know better.
I think I could ever tell her.
You had to.
Yeah, I know, I know. The way she left.
I guess she knows she can't stop you. No one can.
How do you mean?
Well, your music's all that matters to you.
Why can't she understand?
Still, she's right, you know.
Oh, you
don't get mad. She is. What about you not belonging in dives like this? And music like yours is being played in theaters and high-class hotels. And...
Sure, in New York.
Then that's where you belong.
Well, that's easy for you to say. But...
Not easy at all, Jean. Because if you go, Eddie goes with you, and then there'd be two of you to miss.
Hey, Eddie.
Yeah.
Listen, did you ever think of making New York? Well, Davy Tuff connected.
Yeah, man, but,
Oh,
Listen, maybe she'll come too. Well, she always wanted to make that Juilliard in Carnegie Hall.
Hooray!
Come on, Eth, let's get out of here.
Is not allowed in the room. No practicing after midnight, and that'll be 1 week's rent in advance. And don't try to sneak your buddies in here to sleep on the chairs. I'm wise to that.
Well, welcome to the big city. You know, I think we should have gone to the Y like Ethel did.
What for? We won't be living in this joint long enough for it to matter. Hello, big town. Are you ready?
Ethel sure mends a fine collar.
Yeah, she does pretty good with the socks, too. From rags to rags in one generation.
Hey, Gene.
Yeah?
How about packing this town in and going home, huh?
Never. Not until we've made it.
But it's been over 3 months. If there are no jobs for us, what are you going to do?
There will be. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, if we live long enough. Look. Look, I'm no mental giant, so sometimes I'm a little slow on the upbeat, but you would rather hock your drums than play bread and butter jobs.
Look, we didn't come here to play at poker parties or to whoop it up on a truck at election rallies. Eddie, we came here to make a certain kind of music, and that's what
we... And nobody wants us?
Well, they do. They just don't know about it.
Tell me something. Tell me, what is it with you, pride or something? Look, I know you're a hardhead, but don't you understand something? That they want it strictly from the Cobb, Ted Lewis, and Waltz Me Around Again, Willie. The manager. Seems like every jazz man in town has more experience
than we. Where did all this come from?
The market.
Well, what'd you use for money?
Money? I got a job. Switchboard operator at the Hotel Edison.
Good evening, Hotel Edison. One moment, please. I'll connect you with room service. Good evening, sir.
No, sir. There's nobody cooking food in this room. Ain't nobody here but us chickens.
What about Carnegie Hall and all of the symphonies you came here to write?
Well, I can do both.
Ethel, what did you do a thing like that for? I mean, sometimes I just don't understand you, Eth.
Sorry, I didn't mean to jump all over you.
Did you?
Well, it's just that you've been washing and sewing and ironing for us, and now you want to feed us.
Ah, what's the matter with us that you have to go out and work for us?
Wouldn't you do as much for me or Eddie? Of course you would. I just found a job first. That's all. I gotta run. Talk to you later.
Hotel Edison, one moment, please.
Yes.
I'll make it up to you.
You don't have to.
No, I do, I do. You're a wonderful gal, if you know that, don't you?
Well, that's just a rumor I started. Besides, I think you're wonderful, too. So we're even. Good night, Jean.
Good night, cold hands.
Are they? Hold me, Jean. Close. So close that nothing can ever come between us. Don't look at me.
Ev, what are we getting ourselves into? Eddie's expecting to marry you.
No, he's not. Not anymore. He knows how I feel about you.
Oh, I wish I understood you.
I wish you did, too.
Eddie's one of the nicest, best-looking guys. Why?
He's a wonderful guy. I'm no good for anybody else but you, Jean. I never was. Please never let me go.
Man, watch me make a slob of myself. I'm so tired of those salt and pepper sandwiches.
Where'd you go?
Out. Looking the natives over. I didn't want to be in the way.
Listen, Eddie, Look, I want you to know I never try to cut you out or make time or anything like that.
I know you didn't. You didn't have to. That girl looks at you like she's just sighted land. You know, even while you're at the seminary, she was kind of torturing like the Statue of Liberty. I figured maybe she'd have to get over it, but... Look, I never really stood a chance. I don't know how you feel about her, but I...
Well, I'm gonna marry her.
On the level?
First job I get.
She could die an old maid that way. Hey, guess who I met in the lobby?
Who'd you meet in the lobby?
Davy Tuff, remember?
Yeah, sure, I remember.
He said to stay alone. How come we to make a DD some night?
All right, I'll bite. What's a DD?
Oh, I don't know. Session at the Rista Donnell's place. The Lady D. That's where all the big guys drop in after hours. Dorsey, T. Garden, Red Nichols.
Dorsey, T. Garden, Red Nichols. Did you get the address?
Yeah.
Then what are you waiting for? Come on, let's go.
Hi,
Dave.
You remember Jean?
Sure, how are you? Ethel, nice to know you. Come on. Man, somebody wake me up.
How about this?
What a way to live. I'm gonna have a place just like this. And soon, way up high.
There goes Red Nichols.
And there goes Dorsey.
And here goes Krupa.
With them?
Careful with those drums, Sonny.
she's a name, Tommy. This is my brother, Jimmy.
How you doing? I'm Red Nichols. Wow, you kick a lot of drums, Jack.
Gene Krupa.
Hey, guess what? Red Nichols asked me to hang around. He wants to talk to me about working in his band for the new George Gershwin show, Strike Up the Band. Isn't that wild, Ed? Oh, Ed, I'm on my way. My luck is changing, Ed. I'm on my way. This is no time to be sleeping, Cinderella. Yeah, we're all going up to Harlem for some barbecued spare ribs, which Nichols says is the most. Yeah. No, honey, that was last time. No, I know, honey, but this is a different place. Yeah, hey, listen, and then we're all going up to Charlie Sims after that to play some... Oh, darn it, I forgot you got school in the morning. Yeah, I'm sorry. Hey, you should have been to the party we went to after we got through at the club. Oh, very, very, high society. And you know what it got us, huh? A record date with, Dorissa Donnell, huh? Only she's never done real jazz before, so keep your fingers crossed a week from Tuesday.
Hey, wonderful. That's my birthday.
Hey, that's right. Well, that'll give us two things to celebrate. Oh, Ethel, I'm telling you, more things are happening. I'm really beginning to move now. What with the... Oh, darn it. Honey, I'm not going to have time to take you to lunch today. I have this interview with Downbeat magazine. They're doing a thing on Chicago jazz. And after that, I'm meeting Redwood and some friends for cocktails. And then I gotta meet the man who runs the Jack of Clubs and the... Honey, I'm sorry. How about dinner at the club?
How about a nice, quiet sandwich somewhere, just the two of us?
When?
You say when.
I'll call you later, huh? Hey, wish me luck, huh?
Three, can't you hear a pitter-patch?
Is this what you meant by real jazz backing? Because it sounds more like a razor fight in the dark to me, all that racket. And those drums. I'm sure all that boom, boom would knock the needle to hell and go.
The technicians.
I said I'm sure.
Maybe that's what rehearsals are for.
I know what they're for. I'm not sure that they do.
Sorry, I'll try to hold
it
down.
You ought to be. Do we need these pots and pans?
No.
After all, I am not a cooch dancer, and we are not doing the zombies mating call, you know, which may come as a big shock to you. Got a better idea. There. Now you can bang your pretty head off, just to show you my heart is in a good place.
Your what?
Snow again, Junior. I didn't quite get your drift.
I said, thank God I'm not a mink.
Aren't you, though? Can we try it once again?
Tempo, Jackson. She'll tear your ears off just for souvenirs.
Laying her pussycat on my base just...
Gino.
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries, leave them on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear a pitter-pat?
Yeah, I'd love to, Tom, but it's my girl's birthday, and I promised I'd take her to a late show, you know, and some supper, and, well, I wouldn't want to disappoint her.
Okay, Gino. Tell her happy birthday for me.
See you, Tom.
Now,
Now, that wasn't so bad, was it?
Oh, man, did you put her down? Time somebody did. My compliments, maestro.
What are we giving away here?
The most. One sip and you're gone from the Vale of Tears.
Reefish?
Reet, the tenderweed. Or as the peasants say, tea, and I don't mean oolong.
So that's who they look like, huh?
Don't give me that, Daddy-O. How else would you get that crazy kick on your drums?
Oh, come off it, Jack. You think I need anything like that to get me out there?
Stand up, Dad. They're going over your head.
Drummer boy, do you have a minute? Half a minute?
Haven't I heard what you've got to say?
I'm trying to apologize.
Yes, sir. Anything else, sir?
If I let you go away mad, you'd spook me the longest day I lived. That's how I am. And I don't like to eat alone. So why don't we have supper or breakfast or both and get to like each other? We ought to if you're going to do all my record dates. I'm not going to bite you.
I'm not worried about you biting me. It happens to be a girl.
There always is. Does that mean we can't have a drink and talk for an hour or so?
It's her birthday and we're celebrating it tonight.
And you're afraid she won't wait, huh? And I thought it was just me you were scared of. Maybe if you called her and asked, pretty please. Good. Come and scrub my back. What a night. You know how much champagne you put away?
Uptown. Yeah, I had a call and apologize for not seeing you last night or telephoning.
That's all right. Eddie explained that you'd gotten hooked into some extra work and that you'd be busy most of the night. You must be exhausted with all.
Oh, never mind me. What did you do?
I waited. Like the foolish girl I am.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Eth. Listen, Eth, I gotta go now. Can I see you tonight?
Can you?
At the club.
It's all right.
And oh, listen, Eth, happy birthday.
Thanks, Jane. Goodbye.
We'll be right back. morning, Gina. Say something wrong?
My mother invited her to come and visit and stay at the new apartment. And I know she'd like to see how well I'm doing.
Sure.
She says she can't. But she won't. She says she prays for me. And she's happy for me if I enjoy this life. I wanted her to enjoy it. I wanted to see her face get happy for me.
Take it easy. Okay, fellas. Tingo.
Larissa Donnell, the singer. And sitting next to her is Mark Hellinger, the columnist. Next to him is Speaker Willis, the top agent in the business, and they want me to join them.
I see.
Oh, come on, don't say it that way.
Well, you have to, don't you?
No, it's not that. Well, you know how important it is for me to meet people like that.
And?
And I may get Speaker Willis to handle me.
And you don't want me there? You can say it, Gene.
Okay. If you want me to stay, I will. If you really
no,
want...
No, I don't. Not like that. After all, I'm not your wife. I'm just... What am I, Gene?
I'm sorry. I just don't want to be in the way.
Ethel, you're not.
Good night,
it's
Jean.
Just...
Hey, Eth.
Okay, let me get you a cab.
Thanks. I can manage.
Honey, you do understand, don't you?
I think I do.
Drums is a solo instrument. I don't know how anybody who looks like his mama's own angel child can explode like that and knock everybody's plaster loose.
Try to reach you all last night.
Well, how sick is she?
Well, not very. But she is my mother, and... well, I haven't been home in a long time.
Yeah. Sorry, Ed. It's funny, I miss you already.
That's an improvement already.
Like I told you, it took a little longer than I figured, but I made it.
Ah, you talk about class. Hey, you haven't seen anything yet. Just wait until you see the view. Come on, Eddie. I'm telling you, I haven't seen anything like this except that DD's, only this is better. Look. Seventeen floors up and all of Central Park for your ashtray.
Not mine, I can't afford it.
Well, you don't have to. You're my buddy, aren't you?
I don't understand something. Last month you moved to
that was last month.
Place.
Eddie boy, we gotta try real hard to be satisfied with the best. Well, that's what making money is for, to have a good time before it all caves in on you.
Yeah, like the mine shaft did on my old man's leg. Hey, we got a lot of fun to catch up on, and this is the place for it. Hey, I can't wait until I see Ethel's face when she gets back from Chicago.
Yeah, if she gets back.
I thought her mother was getting better.
I don't think she went just because of her mother, do you? Anyway, I got a letter from her yesterday.
Oh?
Yeah, she asked me whether I thought she had to come back or not.
How come she asked you?
Because I'm a friend.
And what am I, her enemy?
Well, don't get hot. You know, she wasn't exactly happy around here.
Yeah, like I know. But whose fault is it we were hardly ever awake at the same time? Well, you know what it is for jazz blowers. If it isn't a job 6 nights a week, it's a rehearsal or a bed.
Yeah, or a new girl. You know, you even had me fooled for a while. I really thought you were going to marry that
Well,
guy.
I am going to marry
Yeah,
her.
Like when?
Oh, you want to tell me when?
Do you want me to tell you?
G.
Jean, don't you understand something? That she's not gonna stand still for all that goop? That you're gonna have to make a choice? Why?
Eddie, what good is making good if you can't have everything that goes with it? The parties, the kicks. Oh, those gals mean nothing to me. You know that. Well, why can't she understand that?
I think she does, Jean. It isn't much, but he calls it home.
But why? This must take every dollar he earns.
Yeah, and some he hasn't earned yet.
Something. Every time I see you, you're looking better. Only this time, you're looking like the next time. Welcome back, F. Yeah, I'm sorry I couldn't meet you at the station, but I...
Gina, look at who I brought.
Hey, Bunny! Excuse me. Bunny, baby!
You know nice Bunny Berrigan and Frankie Trombone?
Frankie?
Big Spiderbeck?
Big Spiderbeck, how are you?
And me?
And me. Come on in, everybody, come on. Come on.
Oh, yes. I knew.
Thanks, everybody.
Hello, Jean. Hello, pal. Beautiful, marvelous party. Look who I brought. A couple of Ziegfeld Follies rejects. I got one more to show you. Little card trick. Watch this one, Jean. Four of hearts. Seven of diamonds. Queen of spades. Nine of clubs. Nine of diamonds. Ace of spades. Four of hearts. Queen of clubs. Nine of diamonds. Ace of spades. Four of hearts. Queen of clubs.
Where's the cards?
What?
Where's the cards?
I can't do it with the cards. This one is an imitation of an aeroplane that is pow, pow.
Hey, tell me, you seen Eddie?
Sorolla?
Yeah.
I saw him leave with your girl. Why?
It's a good question. Why? All right, come on. What gives?
She wanted to leave, so I put her in the cab.
Alone?
Well, that's how she wanted it. She's a funny girl, Gene.
Yeah, hilarious. Where'd she go?
To the Edison.
Smile like you're glad to see me.
I am. Doesn't always show.
Aren't you gonna invite me in?
No, Jane. It's just a room. A small room without a view.
Oh, I get it. You're mad at me because I didn't meet you at the station, huh?
That would have been nice.
Well, didn't Eddie explain? You think I should have blown the whistle on the whole party? Sent all of my friends packing? The greatest names in jazz?
No.
Then why did you walk out?
Because all of a sudden, I could. Once I didn't think I could ever stop hearing those drums in my head. Or wondering where you were and what you were doing. And whom you were doing it with. Oh, gee, let me finish. I don't know what happened to that boy I knew in Chicago, but...
He grew up. All the way up. Only you don't approve.
What I don't approve of is my being a sometime thing, Jean, a convenience, not even yours. I tried to be, but it made love a dirty word, messy.
Don't talk that way.
How would you like me to talk, pretend it? I'm going to
to stone you out of my life, Jean, even if it kills me. I know nobody ever died from that. It sure feels like I may be the first.
Ethel, what is it you want?
Too much.
I know, marriage. You want us to live locked up in each other's pockets like we...
I want you to say goodnight.
Then why did you come back?
Because hope can be very foolish. Good night, Jean.
Waking skies at sunrise, every sunset too seems to be bringing me memories of you. Here and there, that we once knew, and they all just recall memories, memories of you. How I wish I could forget those yesteryears that have left a rosary of tears. Your face beams in my dreams, spite of all I do and everything seems to bring memories of you. Your face beams in my dreams.
Where have you been?
In spite of all I do.
Way out.
Everything seems.
Who's a snake charmer?
Anita O'Day. Not bad if you like talent.
Speak, I've been thinking. And that's not easy for me. I want to front my own group. I think I'm ready.
It'll take a lot of money, Gene.
Well, what doesn't? Set it up with a long tour to break it in right.
Well, Gene, I'm not sure I can.
If you can't, I'll have to get somebody who can.
You're pretty young for the...
She said she
didn't want to... Can we talk about something else?
Telling me she was going to stone me out of
her life. I said, can we talk about something else?
Hey, wait a minute. Since when can I talk without checking you first?
Since you decided to discuss her, that's when. Like this, I don't want her name kicked around.
You don't want?
That's right, I don't want. So let's talk about something else, all right?
Well, let's not, Eddie, buddy, because I don't have to talk to you at all.
Yeah, well, that's all right, too.
That's with Mother Sirota.
What's with everybody?
Oh, Who's the girl you...
Shut up and give me a cigarette.
Gino, put your miseries out to pasture and nobody gets you.
Listen, Eddie, Eric there tells me there's this crazy bongo joint downtown where the natives really kick it in. Wanna come?
Sure. Well, I can drive.
Translate, please.
Last week, he almost got us pulverized in that car.
So that was last week. It almost doesn't count. Oh, what's the matter? You want to live forever? Okay, Eric, it's enough.
Nope, just as long as I can. You're in no shape to handle that buggy. Half the time you're not tracking, the other half the time you're not caring. Well, you'd be plenty worried about not being able to hold on to those sticks.
Who can't? What's the matter? Didn't you ever have an accident?
Gene, you gotta come down. The way you've been going, you're gonna wind up in a hospital.
It's the only way to go, if you're gonna go at all. Big.
No, not big. Bigger. Everything's gotta be bigger for you. Bigger, bigger, than bigger
oh,
than that.
Wow,
until something.
My buddy's been on the full moon. Now, you wanna tell me success is bad?
No, success is when you can stop worrying about it. Success is when you can handle it, and you can't, not even nearly. Yeah, like all wonder boys who start...
Why are you preaching next Sunday, Daddy? Because I want to be sure I miss it. All I did was invite you to a Bible
All right,
session.
All right, so don't get hot.
Then don't go telling me what to do.
Yeah, wouldn't that be something? Anybody telling you anything. Look, if you're going to break your neck, that's fine. But you do it without me. Because this is where I'm getting off.
Oh, come on, what is this, a threat?
No, it's just something I should have done a long time ago, Gene.
He'll change his mind.
No, he won't. Not this time.
Tough tiddlywinks. He keeps raining all the time.
You know, I don't mess with that stuff anymore.
That's what's wrong with you.
Thought I got you off of it, too.
You did. But...
Is your coat?
Yeah, sure. Why? What's good? Hey, what is this?
An arrest.
Now, look, fellas, if this is your idea of a gag,
these two
I'm
envelopes,
tired.
One of them containing 37 marijuana cigarettes, reefers. The other containing two, one of them half smoked, found in your coat pocket.
In my pocket? Oh, now I know this is
your
a gag.
Your man here was a witness.
Sure, I'd mess with some reefers. Don't ask me why, because I don't know. Maybe I had to see what everybody was talking about. Maybe I was low and I thought it might be kicks. Like somebody drinks too much or gambles more than he meant to. Or messes with a woman he thinks is poison. Because that's exactly what it is. That stuff not only threw my timing off, but it made my sticks kind of slippery and... So if there's a rap for having messed with this stuff once, I guess I got it coming to me. But those reefers were not mine. Mr. Nell can testify to that.
Oh, hey, hold it. Let's not drag little old me into this. That's why we have Mr. Harlock here, who is only the best lawyer in town. And he says possession of marijuana is only a misdemeanor. You plead guilty and...
To what? Listen, I'm telling you the truth.
I know you are. Otherwise, you'd have been caught in the act, or they'd have been found on you. But the fact is, they did find them. I talked to your valet. It could look very bad in court.
But who would want to frame me?
Well, it could be anybody.
A jealous woman, a musician you fired, a peddler, a vice crusader, hipped on musicians. You're a sitting duck. Of course, we'll have Miss Donnell on the stand.
No, you won't. You get me up there, and I'm one dead duckling.
You are our key witness, Miss Donnell.
The hell I am. I'd never get rid of the smell.
It's very important.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a towel I'd better get out of.
Boy, there are smells and smells, huh?
Yes? Who? Just a moment, please. It's for you.
I'm not here.
It's your mother.
Mama? Ma, don't cry. There's nothing to worry. No, I don't want you to come. Because you'd only get yourself hurt by all the news. I know that doesn't matter to you, Ma, but... And I love you for it, but what good would it do? I want to see you too. But not now, not this way. Ma, why didn't you want to see me when things were going good? Why now? No, Ma. No, I needed you more then. Why didn't you ever understand that? On my way back to New York. Now, you take care of yourself, you hear me, Ma? Please try not to worry. You see, I got myself a real great lawyer, yeah. Thanks, Ma. I do, too.
Just took a bum rap, you're doing.
What rap, Mr. Hollock? Look, it's all over and done with. And as soon as I pay you the rest of the tab and blow this town, it'll be like it never was. Only I, look, I can't pay it now. I'm kind of broke, but. Only until I get to New York.
Gee, when'd you get back? You're looking great.
Well, it was about 3 or 4 weeks.
Fine.
Listen, did Willis talk to you about me?
No, about what?
About your drum spot. Do I hear an offer?
For you? Oh, Marone, what I wouldn't give to have you on those drums.
Well, here I am.
Yeah, but Gene, how could I? That pressure's worse than ever. You know what would happen to me if I was to give a job to an addict?
Is that what you think I am?
No, of course not, Gene. I know you're not. But they don't know it. They think you are. Kid They'd crucify me with my head hanging down, and then we'd both be out of the business.
You mean I can't even work for you?
It'd be like cutting my own throat, kid. I'm sorry.
I'll see you, Kenny.
What's going on, Speaker? Because something sure is, and let's not waltz me around.
Well, the heat's still on, Gene. The musician so much as smiles on a bandstand, he's suspected of being a dope fiend.
So?
So nobody is exactly anxious to stick his neck out. Not even for you.
You should have told me. Letting me walk around embarrassing everybody like I was a two-headed beggar.
Come on, it'll pass, Gene. 6 months or so after the election, then all these reformers will be back.
And just what do I do for those 6 months or so, huh? Go nuts banging away on my practice pad, too ashamed to look at anybody in the face? Because that's what I am, Speaker, and it's not a good feeling.
Something may turn up.
Yeah, sure. Sure. Beg long enough or crawl long enough. Well, I'd rather cut my tongue out. Dope peddlers stop me in the street, call me up at home, and... give me anything at all.
Anything at all is liable to be pretty far out of town.
Well, it can't be far out enough, because this town is like a died and left me, a good riddance.
If you're sure, Gene.
How many watches do you think I have left to hawk, huh?
You missed the tempo change, Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones, didn't you mark it?
Oh, I got it.
I hope so. This is my eighth year with this hotel, and nobody's gonna compromise my standards.
Well, nobody's gonna compromise mine either. Look, you may not know who you're talking to.
Huh. I know precisely who I'm talking to, Mr. Jones. I owed Willis a favor, which is why I took the chance with you. Now you just behave and play my music precisely
as... what? I've heard better music coming from a squeaky floorboard. Much better. Quiet.
When I tell you to, your name up in lights, this joint will be mobbed. Gene Krupa in Poison. The champ himself on a comeback trail.
Well, not me. I'm no freak in a sideshow.
Okay. You're a great star. Let's do it my way, Cookie, huh?
And absurdity. That's all it is.
So get tall, man. Get tall, and to hell with them all. Just open up the golden gate.
Get off me.
Well, how else are you gonna stand it?
Get off me, I said! I'm sorry.
You see what I mean? Look at those hands, shaking like they were waving goodbye. No wonder you can't hardly hold on to those sticks.
Now, who's gonna believe it? Here I am, a million miles from nowhere, locked up in a dead letter office, and you drop in. Now, what are you doing in a joint like this?
How are you, Gene?
Surprised, mostly. I guess I can do with a couple of shaves and a pressing, huh? You look good, Eth.
I spent all day trying.
What brought you to Philly?
A train. I finally found out where you were, so I thought I'd come down and catch some of that scary Krupa drumming.
You shouldn't have. Oh, you don't belong in a dump like this.
Neither do you. How long has it been?
8 months, years, I don't know, I forget.
What are you doing about it?
Like I do when it rains, I let it rain. Pretty clever of me, huh? It's only a matter of time, and I'll be right back on top again. Bigger than ever.
Oh, great. Because, well, when I heard that you've been playing in chop suey parlors and strip joints, I sort of began to wonder.
What else have you heard?
Tommy Dorsey's forming a band.
Where'd you hear that from, Eddie? How is he?
Fine. If you're planning to see Dorsey about getting a job...
About eating some more crow? No, no thanks. He knows where to find me.
Would you mind very much if I got to Dorsey and talked to him about you? Because I don't have that kind of pride. Or I could get someone else to find out how he feels about
you. Well, I can tell you how he feels about me. Number one, there's the blacklist. And even if there wasn't, his men have to read music, and I mean read.
And you still haven't learned. You knew that and didn't do anything about it.
Did what? Go to school like a kid learning how to play the tom-toms? And from whom? Jokers who wouldn't know it was the Star-Spangled Banner unless everybody was standing up. Hey, I'm Gene Krupa, remember?
Gene Krupa, I remember, would never have let anything or anyone stop him. Not for long.
Go home, Eth. Look, if the speaker sent you here,
Nobody sends me. You ought to know that, Gene.
All right, he asked you to come.
He asked me not to. Said I was a very foolish girl. As if I didn't know that. Because he thinks that success for you is... was like whiskey to an alcoholic.
Then why do you bother?
Because I can't sit by while you let yourself disappear, Gene. That's what's happening.
I wish I understood you.
I wish you did, too.
When I had everything, I mean everything, money, jobs, friends, you brushed me.
You gave me the rap for making it big.
No,
now
I'm making it big, Gene, for not being big enough to handle it. Because if you could make a solo instrument out of drums and without a single lesson set millions of people on fire with them, what couldn't you do once you got your mind around to it? Didn't they scream, go, Gene, go, and you went and took them with you like nobody'd ever done before, not on drums. If you tried, you could.
What do you think I've been trying to do?
Not enough, otherwise.
Oh, since when do you know everything? As if learning how to read music was the whole almighty answer.
It'd be better than nothing and a lot better than hiding. Because that's what you're doing, Gene, hiding from what? What could be worse than this? Or don't you even care anymore?
You don't leave me very much of myself to like.
I wasn't trying to.
And some sparkling champagne. Let there be birds to sing in the trees. And someone to bless me whenever I sneeze.
Gene.
Hi, Eddie.
Oh, it's good to see you.
It's good to see you too, Ed. Been a long time, huh?
Yeah, too long. Have you been?
Fine, fine. You know. Now, what am I going to tell you?
What's to tell me? It's good to see your ugly puss again. So what are your plans?
Plans? Well, I just thought I'd drop down and say hello, you know, and just in case somebody was having a hard time reading these fly specs. You know, I kind of like this change you got here, Eddie. Yeah, this D-flat chord against the B-flat. What's the matter? Didn't you know even kids could learn how to read music? Especially if their coach is from the New York Philharmonic. Hey, you want to see the scars?
You took lessons, huh?
Yeah, yeah, quite a few.
Hey, Gene! Good to see you.
It's good to see you too, Tom.
How are you?
Available. Do I hear an offer?
Look, Gino, I'd love to use you in the Tubs, but I'll tell you, I just...
No, let me tell you. It's a new band, see, and the pressure is still on, and the...
And you're all wet. I'm a music man. What I care is whether men can make music good enough. And you're more than good enough. But I have a drummer. You must know Davey.
Sure. Well, they don't come any better.
I'm sorry, Gene.
Come on, don't be sorry. Nice to see you again, Tom, and good luck, huh?
You too.
Hey, Mr. Dorsey, can I see you a minute?
Excuse me, Mom.
It's just as well.
Why? What are you talking about?
I don't know. They probably wouldn't accept me out there. I'm not sure I can make it, Ed. I'll see you, Ed.
No, now, wait a minute. Don't go away. Stay here a minute, huh? Hey, Tommy, I've got an idea.
Krupa? Mr. Krupa? Good luck, Mr. Krupa. And don't worry about the crowd. No matter what they do, you're...
Places, Mr. Krupa. Right away, please.
Back up.
after too long an absence, Gene Krupa. Let's give him a great big welcome. Let's hear it.
Thank you.
always knew he'd make it again. You also know this is the surest way to lose him?
He never was mine to lose.
See you back in the old groove again, Daddy. Man, it's just like old times, man. It's just like old times.
Yeah, man. Remember those parties?
Yeah, that was a while
ago. Used to go on for days. I knew a guy who was never heard from again.
Hey, where you going, man? Ain't you coming to our party?
Thanks, Dad. I've been to that party. See you, fellas. Thanks a lot.
Hey, Jim. Hey, Jim, where you going?
Oh, you know where I'm going.
Hey,
now, where do you think you're going?
Away.
Without me? Some chance. What's the matter? Didn't you think I'd ever learn?